We all love to play games with very high resolution and textures. Games look even better if everything looks more realistic. And if it's a virtual reality game, it stands out from the competition. Will movies like Ready Player One become a reality in the future? We are discussing about the past, present, and future of virtual reality gaming in today's video of DiscoverZen. We all know that computational power is growing at an extremely fast rate in the recent decades. We came so far that our smartphones are much faster than the computers used in Apollo 11 rocket. At the current growth, it's quite possible that virtual reality will be common in the upcoming years. Before moving forward, let's see the major differences between augmented reality and virtual reality. Virtual reality, or VR, is the use of computer technology to create a simulated environment. Unlike traditional user interfaces, virtual reality places the user inside an experience. Instead of viewing a screen in front of them, users are immersed and able to interact with 3D worlds. On the other hand, augmented reality, or AR, is an interactive experience of a real-world environment where the objects that reside in the real world are enhanced by computer-generated perceptual information, sometimes across multiple sensory modalites, including visual, auditory, haptic, somatosensory, and olfactory. Examples of augmented reality games can be Pokemon Go and Ingress, whereas for VR, it's Beat Saber and Superhot. The major reason for VR to be more successful is that the experience can be very immersive in a realistic environment. It could be similar to or completely different from the real world because everything is simulated using computer programming. But the applications of VR is not only limited to gaming, but also to medical or military training and many other interactive educational topics. Currently, standard virtual reality systems use either virtual reality headsets or multi-projected environments to generate realistic images, sounds, and other sensations that simulate a user's physical presence in a virtual environment. A person using virtual reality equipment is able to look around the artificial world, move around inside it, and interact with virtual features or items. This effect is commonly created by VR headsets consisting of a head-mounted display with a small screen in front of the eyes, but can also be created through specially designed rooms with multiple large screens. Virtual reality typically incorporates audio and video feedback, but may also allow other types of sensory and force feedback through haptic technology, a better experience for the users. Now, let's take a look at some of the work being done by the companies in VR tech. In 2010, Palmer Luckey designed the first prototype of the Oculus Rift. This prototype, which was built on a shell of another virtual reality headset, was only capable of rotational tracking. However, it boasted a 90-degree field of vision that was previously unseen in the consumer market at the time. It had some distortion issue at the launch, which was fixed in a couple of software patches. In 2014, Facebook acquired Oculus VR for around $3 billion. In 2013, Valve discovered and freely shared the breakthrough of low-persistence displays, which makes a lag-free and smear-free display of VR content possible. This was adopted by Oculus and was used in all their future headsets. In early 2014, Valve showed off their Steam Sight prototype, the precursor to both consumer headsets released in 2016. It shared major features with the consumer headsets including separate 1K displays per eye, low persistence, positional tracking over a large area, and Fresnel lenses. HTC and Valve announced the virtual reality headset HTC Vive and controllers in 2015. The set included tracking technology called Lighthouse, which utilized wall-mounted base stations for positional tracking using infrared light. In 2014, Sony announced Project Morpheus, a virtual reality headset for the PlayStation 4 video game console. In 2015, Google announced Cardboard, a do-it-yourself stereoscopic viewer. The user places their smartphone in the cardboard holder, which they wear on their head. Michael Neymark was appointed Google's first-ever resident artist in their new VR division. The Kickstarter campaign for Glove One by NeuroDigital Technologies, a pair of gloves providing motion tracking and haptic feedback, which was successfully funded with over $150,000 in contributions. Today, Glove One can be used with both hands to sense and interact with virtual objects on screen/VR glasses. By 2016, there were at least 230 companies developing VR-related products. Amazon, Apple, Facebook, Google, Microsoft, Sony, and Samsung all had dedicated AR and VR groups. dynamic binaural audio was common to most headsets released that year. However, haptic interfaces were not well developed, and most hardware packages incorporated button-operated handsets for touch-based interactivity. Visually, displays were still of a low enough resolution and the frame rate in which images were still identifiable as virtual. In 2016, HTC shipped its first units of the HTC Vive Steam VR headset. This marked the first major commercial release of a sensor-based tracking, allowing for free movement of users within a defined space. A patent filed by Sony in 2017 showed they were developing a similar location tracking technology to the Vive for PlayStation VR, with the potential for the development of a wireless headset. In 2019, Oculus released the Oculus Rift S and a standalone headset, the Oculus Quest. These headsets utilized inside-out tracking compared to the external outside-in tracking seen in previous generations of headsets. Recently, Facebook launched the second-generation Oculus Quest for $299. Quest 2 pushes the state of VR forward with a redesigned all-in-one form factor, new touch controllers, and a display resolution of 1832 by 1920 pixels per eye. Powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon, XR2 platform, and 6GB of RAM, it's supposed to run everything much faster than any other VR headsets in the consumer market. The company stated that it will support up to 90Hz displays and also the best VR games and experience ever. Now, let's talk about the major concerns among the end users. Privacy. The persistent tracking required by all VR systems makes the technology particularly useful for, and vulnerable to, mass surveillance. The expansion of VR will increase the potential and reduce the costs for information gathering of personal actions, movements, and responses. And some of the big names, such as Oculus, is now owned by Facebook, so you can understand the point here. So what does the future for VR look like? With the lockdown restrictions in 2020, VR is experiencing an enormous rise. According to Grandview Research, the global VR market will grow to $62.1 billion in 2027. Between 2020 and 2027, market researchers expect an annual growth rate of over 20%. Does this all mean that we will never touch a computer again once we perfect the VR technology? Well, no. VR is supposed to sit right with the PC as it's more focused on software optimization. Companies need to work harder to make the technology feasible for everyone. Virtual reality is not going to change our current work PC or smartphone for now, but it will certainly change the way we play games or use technology for studies and medical purposes. So, can we see something like Ready Player One become a reality? Probably yes. To reach the level of a Ready Player One game, it requires an extremely high resolution, refresh rates, frame rates, perfected kinesthetic feedback, and most importantly, a mass market. Nearly all of the consumer-ready products, and even those which are pre-commercial but are likely to reach consumer markets within the next year or two, involve tactile feedback. But kinesthetic feedback is found only in high-end and custom systems and is severely lacking in accessible consumer products. Advanced haptics features such as thermal variation are even rare in high-end systems. There is even a game called the Oasis Beta, which was released to coincide with Ready Player One, but it is far from the real projection of the game. According to some VR developers, we would be having enough technology within the next 7 to 10 years to create a game like Ready Player One. We now understand that VR will be on exponential growth in the future. So, let's discuss a different topic, how NASA astronauts are trained. Well, that sounds like a different scenario to discuss on DiscoverZen.